one thing about bay windows and extensions is the piece of external roof, which may not be insulated, small pitched roof. You see where I'm painting up to. You see the mould. I've treated it. This is what I used. So you can spray this on and leave it. Just leave it to dry. We just spray this straight onto the mould. And then I'm using a brush and just work that in. And that's it, leave it to dry. That'll kill the mould. That piece of ceiling has now been insulated from outside. Tiles lifted and insulated. So, like I say, just treating the mould. It's quite a large ceiling that I'm doing. So, I've not really bought any specialist mould paint. All I'm doing is using this. But I'm going to add some of this, no more mould. So, good stuff. I already had the paint, just add a bit of that. Now I can just paint over this, no problem. Always handy to carry something like that with you, because it's not all the time that you know about something like this. You might just get asked to do something. Although the ceiling has been insulated and I've killed off the mould with the Zinsa mould killer, then the MCS3 added into the paint will just help prevent any more regrowth. What I will do is paint the frieze, both sides. This is just near the affected area. And then I'll recoat, working back away from the light. And wherever I run out, I can just refill and I won't have a problem. But as long as I used all what I've mixed at this end. So then, like I say, whatever work up to, it'll just be normal emulsion from there, and I won't have any difference in finish or anything. So you can use this with any water-based paint, any finish, any colour. That's the beauty of it. A lot of these old window bays would never have been insulated, but that's okay now, no problems there. That's the first coat on the ceiling, and got a little bit left for cutting in, and I've got some left in there. Excellent. Just means I didn't have to buy anything special and I could use up what I had. Thank you.